All right, this is what I've always used in the past, some Hornady One Shot. It works okay. Probably, it definitely does not work as good as the stuff I'm making myself. And, you know, for 5.5 ounce can like this, you're looking at a little over 10 bucks. I think it was like right at $11, I think, is what the last time I paid. And out of a can like this, you can only do about 2,000 cases. And then you'd have to use a loading block, like a tray, and then you would just do like, say, 50 or 100 at a time. Well, the way I'm doing it now, you just get yourself a cheap bottle. This is something that I mixed up before. We're not going to mix up anything in it right now. I'm just going to show you. This is the type of bottle you can get. And what you do is you take and you buy some liquid lanolin. This stuff's pretty inexpensive. You can get a 4-ounce bottle of this for about $6 on eBay, or you might be able to find it in like a local health food store. This is not my recipe. This is something I found online and something I've used, so I'll put a link in the bottom of where I found it. You'll mix 1 ounce of liquid lanolin to 12 ounces of isoheat. And basically what this is it's a fuel additive, but this has isopropyl alcohol in it. It has a really high concentration of isopropyl alcohol. So for all extensive purposes, if you can't find this, you can use, you know, just regular isopropyl alcohol. But you want to try to find some that has the highest concentration of alcohol, because the rest is just water. And so if it has a lot of water in it, it takes longer to evaporate. By using this, you have a decrease in the amount of time it takes to evaporate. So there again, you take 1 ounce of liquid lanolin to 12 ounces of isoheat. These you can get a pack of 4 at Walmart for about $7. So out of all that, you can have enough lube to last you forever. This is my lube here. It's the bootleg Case Lube. Originally I did 26 ounces, and you may not be able to see this. I have done thousands and thousands and thousands of cases, and I'm just at about 18 ounces now. That's what I've done. Just to give you an idea here, let me empty this. This is 500 primers I just recently did. Just to give you an idea on how much I've done. A lot of primers in it. Here's the process. Try to make this quick. I take a bag of 500 like this after I've already cleaned them. And this is my lube tray. My lube tray is 12 by 15. So no more 50 at a time. I dump 500 in at a time like this. So you dump your 500 in. Okay, and you see they still got primers in them. They haven't been trimmed. They're just clean, nice and shiny. I take my Case Lube and I shake it up. All right, and then I give this some sprays. So I think that was like 6 sprays. Once I have it sprayed, all right, and that's that. If you want to put more lube on it, you can. I normally don't, it's usually all I go, but just for the hell of it here, I'll give you 2 more. All right, so that's that. Then another thing about this is this lanolin is safe for your skin. The isopropyl alcohol, of course, is safe for your skin. I think people put this in their hair and use it, you know, breastfeeding moms use it. So, you know, it's safe. You don't have to worry about it. All right, so now you see I just lubed up 500. I'm going to give it a few minutes to dry. I'm going to reposition the camera so you can see me process this stuff. I'm going to size it, deprime it, and trim the cases. Let's get this going. When you get your liquid lanolin, you may want to take it and set it into like a glass of hot water. Just drop the bottle into a glass of hot water with the lid on. You know, just leave the lid on, put it in a glass of hot water. It'll help liquefy the liquid lanolin so you can measure it out easier. Another thing I want to show you is, this is a piece of the lube brass. Tell me if you would do this with when you're using Hornady or some other brand. Look, there's one. 2. Same piece of brass, okay? I would never try that right there with any other lube whatsoever. But to me, that's just simply amazing. All right, I'm gonna reset my timer here, move this on. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my trimmer and my vacuum so this will get a little loud. And I'm just gonna run some of these and get this thing knocked out. So there you go. Maybe you'll be able to see the brass there.